Wearable tech firm Garmin continues to deliver some of the best GPS smartwatches in the market. Now, their latest product, the Fenix 7 Pro Series, is no exception with its training and mapping advancements, making it the ultimate companion. Joining us now in the studio to talk about this is Dorothy Jarantilla. She's the Marketing and Business Development Manager of Knots and Vectors Company. Dot, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
And now, it took 3 years before the release of the series, and it's also, well, I would say quite ironic that the 3 years, the pandemic also happened. You know, what did you notice, I guess, about the usual target market of this brand and how their lifestyle, I guess, changed because of the COVID-19 pandemic?
I think what's interesting about people who wear Garmin is that they have a lot of sports in their lives. And during the pandemic, that literally stopped. So now people are now looking at the health features. Can I track my steps? Can I track my heart rate, ECG, the VO2 max? Because these things are now more important to people more than ever, especially after the pandemic. They're like, oh, I need to be healthier now, because if I don't, then I'm just going to get sick and nothing's going to happen to me in my life.
And did you see that after the pandemic, I mean, now we're rebuilding our lives. There's revenge travel, revenge spending. Did you also see, I guess, a revenge active lifestyle?
Yes, that's like, there's so much more sports now. Recently, we released the Garmin Trail Crew. We have about 600 to 800 members in Metro Manila alone. So more people are going out. Younger people are doing golf. More people are trying out tennis, racket sports. We just recently launched this in Paddle Club, a new sport here in the Philippines. So more people are looking for outdoor stuff to do, because they all want to go out. And with Garmin, we have that all in our watch. We have 100 sports apps, regardless of the whole health and benefits that you get from the watch.
Did you see the age range sort of change? Did it become younger or did it become older?
It's now a wider age group. Before the pandemic, we were hitting maybe 30, 35, all the way to 50. Now we're hitting 20, 22. 25. So more people are now more in tune to working out, to being more healthy.
And I mean, smart watches are the newest thing as well. Mm-hmm. I mean, aside from phones, you see everyone also investing in smart watches. Why do you think so?
I think it's an evolution of what we want.
That's really smart, an evolution of what we want.
Yeah, it's so much easier to just look at your watch and be like, oh, I have a text, or somebody liked my photo on Instagram. That's the most basic function of a smartwatch. But now with more tech inside it, like the Fenix has a solar panel as its face. So it's just like more stuff inside it, more health features. I can track my steps, I can track how much water I've drank today. I can even, as a woman, I can track my period with my watch. So it makes it so much easier to be more healthy, to be more conscious about my life now.
And at least there really is a reflection of what is more important now. Health is wealth.
Yep.
And the price range of Garmin, this series definitely shows that.
Yes.
Could you let us know, I guess, what's the new features of the Fenix 7 Pro compared to the other ones?
The Fenix 7 Pro, the whole series is now solar.
One is it in these watches?
This is the Fenix, these three here on the side, and these are the Epix. So the only difference between these two watches is that the Fenix is solar with a memory in pixel display. That means that it's the whole watch face is solar, and what Epix is the AMOLED version of the Fenix. The newest feature would be better battery life. So this one, the max here is 37 days.
37 days of no charging.
No charging at smartwatch mode. And then this one here is 31 days. So they're brothers, basically. We also have a new biosensor, so it's improved health tracking and also sports data optimization. So if you use it a lot for sports, it will just create a better read on your body and make sure that you're able to do everything that you want to do, including
recovery
time.
Can you show us the features, I guess, of like its different apps? I see that you're wearing one.
Yes,
right.
So
now,
it's easier.
Of course.
So even here, you have like all the sports.
Sorry. And then
you have all the sports
here.
Yeah.
Oh, there's
it's
running.
Touchscreen. You even have paddle, golf here, and all of that. And I can even use it to climb hills and have my notifications, my calendar, my wallet, and I can even music inside. Yeah, I can have Spotify inside my watch. And then when I work out, I can just connect it to my phone or my earphones. So I don't have, when I do a run, I don't have to bring my phone around.
So how's the update, I guess, of the watches? You know how for some phones, there's this monthly or sometimes yearly update?
It's automatic.
It's automatic. Yeah. And how about, I guess, the memory storage? That's always the worry of some.
It's quite big because you don't have to have, I believe it's around 36 gigabytes.
And then, can we at least get a sample of the running, which at least most people are very much getting into, I mean.
So it will track your accelerometer the more you move it around. So it will track your whole run. And then it even has a flashlight, like for trail runners, because they usually do trail in the mountains. So it's quite bright.
Oh, so there's also, of course, flashlights. It's really for those living an active lifestyle.
Yeah. And even a distress signal. Hold on. Because it's running, so it's not doing my...
Okay, if you can hear the sounds right now.
Yeah.
So the flashlight, it has a distress signal.
Yeah.
And then it really helps that the battery life is like 37
yes.
days. So for those who do like to go camping, rest assured that you'll be fine and everything, of course, you know, whether it's your breathing,
yes.
your waters, it's all accounted for.
Yes, we even created a distress signal in the watch so that it doesn't, what do you call this? When you're in the mountains and you get lost, there is a distress signal, it's red, so that when you run or when you show it off, it's easily seen.
We also don't use any sound for distress signal because it's not allowed in the mountains. So everything that, to the minute details, Garmin has taken into consideration for the watch.
That's why it also took 3 years to come out with a better version.
And the wait was definitely worth it. But lastly, I guess, tell us about the price range of all these watches in this series.
The cheapest one in this series is at 50,000.
Can you show us which one here?
This one is at 50,000. This is the 7S. It's made, it's smaller, it's at 42 millimeters. And then the most expensive is this one at 69,000. Just because it's also bigger and it also has a longer battery life inside it.
And now I guess if you could review this whole series and you can describe it, I guess, maybe in just one sentence, also as a user itself, how would you describe it?
If you are the type of person that wants data on your fingertips, then the Garmin is for you. If you love the outdoors, if you love to swim, if you love to run, if you are the person who does all of these sports from golf, running, racket sports and all of that,
the Garmin Fenix or the Garmin Epix is the best watch for you.
It's your best partner.
Partner, I think everyone really would want that, especially for the needs that the youth and even like no matter what age it really is. Thank you so much, Dov, for joining us and for telling us more about this series.
Thank you so much, Denise.